So thank you for the short introduction. The subject of my work is multi-objective scheduling of scientific workflows in multi-cloud sites. In this work, we consider multiple objectives, multiple cloud sites, and dynamic provisioning. I work in India, the NIT team, and the Microsoft Research India Joint Center. We have a collaborator with Brazil. I will present my work in some parts. First, I will introduce the context, and then I will define the problem and present the related work. Afterward, I will present our contributions, which is composed of design of multi-site scientific workflow management system, fragment scheduling, and experimental evaluation. Finally, I will end my presentation by a conclusion. Now, let me present the context. Scientific workflows enable scientists to model data processing of scientific experiments in multiple domains, for example, bioinformatics, astronomy, and engineering. A scientific workflow consists of a set of activities and data dependencies. One activity is a piece of work that forms a logical step. Generally, we use scientific workflow management systems to manage and run scientific workflow on big data. The big data can be geographically distributed at different regions. And generally, we use parallel computing techniques to achieve better performance. In this work, we consider a multi-site cloud, which is a cloud with interacted sites, for example, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud, or Amazon EC2. we can execute scientific workflows in multiple cloud sites by partitioning a scientific workflow into different fragments. And then we can execute each fragment at a single cloud site. In this work, we focus on the multi-site scheduling, which is a process to decide where to execute each fragment. We also consider multiple objectives, which is composed of reducing execution time and mental cost. In addition, we also consider the dynamic provisioning, which is a process to provision virtual machines at different cloud sites according to the workload scheduled to the cloud sites. In addition, we also assume that the cost to use virtual machines at different cloud sites are different. For example, in Microsoft Azure, the cost to use a virtual machine of one CPU call for 1 minute is 4.5 cents euro at Azure West Europe, but it is 6 cents euro at West Japan. In this work, we have several contributions. The first one is the design of a multi-site scientific workflow management system. The second one is a multi-site cost model, which is composed of execution time and mandatory cost. The third one is a single-site virtual machine provisioning approach, which is called SSVP, and a new scheduling approach to allocate scientific workflow fragments to different cloud sites with the minimum cost, which is ActGreedy. Finally, we validate our approaches with an extensive experiment evaluation. Now, let me define the problem. In a multi-site cloud, we have distributed data at different cloud sites, and we have a predefined cost function to execute a scientific workflow in a multi-site cloud. We assume that we have different costs of virtual machines at different cloud sites. The problem is how to generate a scheduling plan that minimizes the cost function while respecting the stored data constraints. Sometimes the data cannot be moved because they are very big or because of priority issues. This is the stored data constraint. Next, let me present the related work. There are already many scheduling approaches, but there are basically four types. The first type is a classic methods, for example, genetic and brute force. Genetic transforms scheduling plans until convergence condition is met. And brute force chooses the best scheduling plan from all the scheduling plans. Generally, they have only a single objective, but the scheduling time may be very long. There is a multi-objective single-site scheduling approach, which is ActGreedy. ActGreedy schedules each site to the fragment that needs the least cost to execute, but it is designed for a single site, and it may incur big data transfer among different cloud sites. There is a multi-site single-objective scheduling, log-based. This approach schedules the fragments to where the data is, but it has just a single objective. Another game theory-based task scheduling method exists. This is a multi-site, multi-objective scheduling, but it is designed just considering the static provisioning, which does not consider the dynamic provisioning. There are already virtual machine provisioning approaches for a single cloud site. For example, GrasPCC, but it just assumes that all workloads can be parallelized, and it is designed for a time quantum of 1 hour. This work does not consider the virtual machine provisioning cost and the sequential workload during the execution of scientific workflows, and it has no support for small time quantum, for example, 1 minute in Microsoft Azure Cloud and Google Cloud. Now let me present our contributions. First, let me start with the design of multi-site scientific workflow management system. We have four modules in the system architecture. The first module is the workflow partitioner, which partitions a scientific workflow into different fragments. And then the multi-site scheduler will schedule different fragments into different cloud sites based on the cost model and a scheduling approach. Finally, afterward, a single site initialization module will prepare the environment to execute each fragment at a different cloud site. Finally, the single site execution module executes different fragments at different cloud site. Let me present the execution process by this slide. First, a scientific workflow is partitioned to different fragments. And then each fragment is scheduled to different cloud sites. Afterward, the virtual machines are provisioned at different cloud sites. And the data is transferred to different cloud sites in order to execute the scientific workflow fragment. When we execute the scientific workflow at different cloud sites, we can use the first formula to estimate the cost cost of the execution. But this cost model, it is difficult to provision virtual machines and to estimate the global execution time and monitor cost and to execute a scientific workflow in a multi-site cloud. Thus, we propose our cost function. Our cost function decompose the total cost of a scientific workflow into the cost of each fragment. And we can execute a fragment at a cloud site. Thus, we can use Amdahl's law to estimate the execution time of a fragment at each cloud site. Afterward, we can, based on this execution time and the cost to use virtual machines at each cloud site to estimate the monetary cost of each of the execution of each fragment at each cloud site. Then we can calculate the total cost of a scientific workflow execution in a multi-site cloud. There are other complex formulas, but I won't bother you with them. Based on the cost model, we can generate the relationship between the execution time and the number of CPU cores, and the relationship between the monitor cost and the number of CPU cores, at the in the left figure. Based on the cost model, we can generate a point which is a near optimal number of CPU cores, which correspond to a near minimum total cost. Then, based on this number and our proposed single-site VM provisioning algorithm, we can generate an optimal provisioning plan. And for each different weight of objectives, we can generate different optimal provisioning plans. In order to generate this optimal provisioning plan, we also consider the cost of data transfer and VM provisioning. Based on the single-site VM provisioning and the cost model, we can I can present the fragment scheduling approach. Our scheduling approach is ActGreedy, which is the activity greedy algorithm. In this approach, first we decompose a scientific workflow into different fragments by encapsulating each activity into a fragment. Afterward, different small fragments are grouped to bigger fragments, like this. Afterwards, each fragment is scheduled at the most suitable site. For example, activity 7 and activity 8 are scheduled to site 1 in order to reduce the execution, the mandatory cost. Well, our approach can also make adaptation to the execution environment by making different scheduling plans in order to make good trade-off between execution time and mandatory cost. Let me present this by this slide. Activity 6.3 and 6.4 generate less data compared with 6.5 and 6.6. Thus, it takes more time to transfer data from set 3 to set 4 than to transfer data from set 4 to set 3. Thus, we can schedule activity 7 and activity 8 to set 3 to reduce the execution time to transfer data. And thus, we can reduce the execution time. As a result, when the objective of reducing the execution time is big, for example, 0.9 or 0.5, we can schedule activity 7 and activity 8 at set 3 in order to reduce the total cost. Finally, we made an experimental evaluation to validate our approach. We used the SSVP for VM provisioning at different cloud sites, and we execute SciEvol workflow at three sites of Microsoft Azure cloud. We take West Europe as the coordinator site. We processed different amounts of input data with different weights of objectives from 0.1 to 0.9. We compared our scheduling approach with four approaches, log-based, S-greedy, genetic, and brute force. Compared with the log-based and S-greedy, the total cost of corresponding to our approach is much smaller. And although the total cost of our approach is similar to genetic and brute force, the scheduling time of our scheduling approach is reasonable compared with genetic and brute force. And this is the result of processing 500 fast file. There are other results, but because of time limit, I may show you in the Q&A section. In terms of the total cost based on our cost model and the original cost model, our approach is always better than the other approaches. Although all of the three approaches correspond to almost the same execution time, but at some times our approach is better, which corresponds to less execution time. In terms of mental cost, our approach is always better compared with the local-based and ScGreedy. In terms of the scheduling time, our approach is always reasonable compared with the execution time itself. Well, when the number of activities is big, for example, bigger than 22, or the number of sites is bigger than 7 or 10, the scheduling time of genetic and brute force is bigger than the execution time itself. Now, let me make a conclusion of my presentation. In this work, we designed a multi-site scientific workflow management system, and we proposed a multi-site and cost model, a single-site VM provisioning algorithm, which is SSVP, a fragment scheduling algorithm, which is ActGreedy. ActGreedy is efficient, and it corresponds to less total cost compared with the baseline algorithms, for example, log-based and ScGreedy. In addition, the scheduling time of our approach is reasonable compared with brute force and genetic. There are a list of related publications during my thesis. Thank you.
Do you assume that you have somehow similar pricing model in every site?
Yeah.
I mean that the elements to be paid are the same, CPU, network, and disk. Or, for example, you may have different providers that may have different pricing models.
Yeah.
So is it already considered, or do you have to extend something in your system so as to take it into account?
You mean different providers have different a mental cost model to use virtual machines?
Okay, I will try to rephrase. You may have two different sites, okay?
Yeah.
And maybe the only thing that changed between the site is the price for the CPU per hour.
Yeah.
Okay, that's simple. But let's imagine that now you have a more complex pricing model, that one provider, for example, makes you pay for upload or download, whereas one other doesn't take this. And again, it's not that significant, but can you manage this kind of heterogeneity in the pricing model for the different providers?
So you mean different cloud providers? And this is a very interesting question. Because in this work, we just consider a single cloud provider. Well, when we have multiple cloud providers, we may have different cost model. And in this time, our approach, for example, SSVP approach, in our proposed algorithm, single-site VM provisioning, by our cost model, it works well, and it considers different costs to use virtual machines at different cloud sites. Well, if the cost model provided by different cloud providers are different, we can also adapt our approach to different cost model, and it will always search for the minimum cost to execute a fragment at a single cloud site. So this will be a very interesting future research. Thank you.